Hello, we are from Batch 18. Our project title is Intelligent Accident Detection and Ambulance Rescue System. So, in this project, we have implemented this Intelligent Accident Detection and Ambulance Rescue System using the NodeMCU module for detecting the accident using the NPU6050 sensor, that is interfacing with the GPS module NEO6M for getting the live location of the accident vehicle. And it is sent through IEEE protocol. So here we along with this we can control the traffic lights on in the path of the ambulance using image passing. So the first part of our project is intelligent accident detection. So here the output of the intelligent accident detection is like as. So NPU6050 sensor has 3-4 pins, that is SDA pin, SCL pin and VCC and ground. We are connected as VCC and ground as 3.3 volts and ground pin, and we have used the GPS module NEO6M and IoT module, that is Wi-Fi. It has a Wi-Fi module, it is NodeMCU. It is a friendly IoT device which can be used as a IoT project. So here we will be connecting this ESP8266 with the GPS and NPU6050 sensor. Yeah, this is the GPS transmitter, and the GPS has 4 pins, RX, TX and VCC ground. VCC is connected to 3.3 volts and ground is connected to the ground, and RX, TX are declared as a software serial pins in the program, that is D3 and D4. And here for NPU6050, SCL and SDA pin are interfaced with the NodeMCU to the pins of D1 and D2 respectively in the program. So yeah, this is our project. So this is a fully automated it finds the accident spot, accident automatically, and clear a way to the ambulance. So here this is the code we have written in the Arduino IDE. So this is the installation of NPU6050 sensor. It has as I said, it has accelerometer and gyroscope. Three axis is accelerometer and three axis is gyroscope. So here we have taken the threshold value, minimum and maximum value, three values, dx, dy, dz. We'll be checking the less than maximum value, it should be less than minimum value, and it should be greater than maximum value. For that, it detects as the high disturbance, or else it would be detecting as a normal driving. So here it would be detecting higher disturbance and connects the three functions, Wi-Fi 1-2-3, GPS and mail function. So we'll be going to this Wi-Fi function and GPS function and mail function. So yeah, this is the void Wi-Fi 1-2-3. Here we will be connecting if a accident is detected, high disturbance is occurred. So the NodeMCU will be connected to the Wi-Fi with using the SSID password which will be given in the program. And we'll be generating an IP address, local IP address. So after that, the GPS will be activated here, and we'll be getting the live location, latitude and longitude of the particular accident location, and the date and time as well. So we'll be sending this live location, latitude, longitude and date and time through this email, which is connected through IEEE. We'll be creating an IEEE login ID, and we'll be creating the unique key ID. We'll be pasting here in the program. So we'll be sending, if the accident is detected, the email will be sent, which will be displayed in the serial monitor. So here the output is as like this, normal driving. So here NPU6050 sensor is activated whenever the accident is occurred. So we'll be checking the output. Yeah, it is normal driving, which is normal driving. So now we'll be triggering this NPU6050 sensor by giving some tilt angle. The values will be changed likewise. So here high disturbance is occurred. So this Wi-Fi is connected to the IP address 192.168.1.8. So the Wi-Fi is connected, and the email is sent with the live location using this GPS module NEO6M. ESP DBS will be sending the location to this NodeMCU, and NodeMCU will be receiving it and will be sending through IFTTT protocol through email address. We can also use the Android SMS. So for the prototype purpose, we have used here email ID to send the live location of a particular accident. So here is the output. So here the output is as help is required as soon as possible, and the link is activated. Link is given. Live location link and the latitude and longitude 17.317 and longitude 28.577, and the date and accident is detected at the June 22 at 11:58 p.m. So now we will be checking this link and we will be verifying the location with the present our location. So now we will be clicking this location. So here the link will be opened to this Google Map. So we have taken the Google Map link as in the from the Google Maps server. So here the pointed location is the live location of my home. So this is the actual live location. This is our project, Intelligent Accident Detection. So this is the live